Hello everyone, this is Bowen. Nice to see you again. Today I'm going to show you the impedance-based stability analysis for three-phase balanced power converter system using generalized Nyquist criteria.
First, let's review the impedance-based stability analysis for DC power system. DC distributed power system is widely used in industry. Regulated power converters are constant power loads. Instability could happen between interconnected power converter systems due to the negative incremental resistance behavior of the constant power load. Middlebrook found the similarity between feedback control system and the interconnected converter system. He proposed to study the stability issue of DC converter system by applying Nyquist stability criteria to the impedance ratio between converters. This impedance-based stability analysis can be summarized in four steps. First, averaging. Second, linearization around equilibrium points. Third, find out the output and the input impedance of the system. Fourth, apply Nyquist criteria. Impedance of power converter can be directly measured, so the impedance-based stability analysis is preferred by power converter engineers. AC distributed power system also has a lot of applications. The impedance-based stability analysis for AC system was proposed by Dr. Belk Hyatt in 1997. The procedure is similar to the one of DC system, except two different steps are needed. First, due to the time-varying and periodic nature of AC system, synchronous rotating frame transformation should be applied so that linearization can be done around an equilibrium point. In DQ frame, three-phase AC system becomes two coupled DC systems, different from DC-DC converter. Impedance of three-phase AC converter in DQ frame is a 2x2 matrix. Generalized Nyquist stability criteria should be applied to the impedance ratio in DQ frame. This video will show you the first frequency domain experiment results for this method. Using voltage source inverter and active front-end converter, a 400Hz AC system is created. Feedback control of both converters are designed and implemented. By changing the voltage loop control bandwidth, the system is made stable and unstable. Source and load impedance are measured to apply generalized Nyquist stability criteria. Before we see the experimental results, let's take a look at the DQ impedance tester. The tester has three main parts. First is the digital controller. Second is the injectors, which are three linear power amplifiers. The third part is the computer, which runs the user interface for impedance measurement. The principle of the tester can be simply explained by this diagram. The computer gives the measurement command to the digital controller. Digital controller first synchronizes with the system to be tested. Then it gives the perturbation in DQ frame. These perturbation signals are injected to the system by transferring them to ABC frame. ABC frame perturbation signals are amplified by the power amplifiers and then applied to the system to be tested. Voltage and the current response from the system are collected and transferred to DQ frame by the digital controller. Impedance are calculated by the computer using response signals and perturbation signals. Here are the experimental results. First, VSI is operated under steady state. The load converter is running under the diode rectification mode. Then load converter PWM control is started. The output voltage of the load converter is regulated to 270 volts. The system is running under the stable condition. After measuring the load and source impedance, generalized Nyquist plot shows that the system is stable. The Nyquist plot also shows that the system is close to unstable condition. If the source impedance becomes bigger or the load impedance phase becomes smaller, the system could run into unstable condition. Then, in the second experiment, the WSI output voltage control loop bandwidth is reduced. When the load converter is started, the system runs into unstable condition. The impedance measurement results, as long as the generalized Nyquist plot shows the same conclusion.
This is our test system. On the bench are two three-phase converters. One is three-phase voltage source inverter, working at the south side converters. The other is three-phase boost rectifier, working as the load converter. This is the three-phase DQ impedance tester. On the left is the PC and network analyzer. On the right is three perturbation injectors, which are three power amplifiers. Now, I'm going to run the converter system, which is three-phase voltage source inverter feeding three-phase boost rectifier. First, the inverter is running with high voltage bandwidth, which makes the system stable. On the scope, the yellow one is the three-phase boost rectifier output voltage. It regulates from 130 volts to 270 volts. 270 volts is the steady state. You see the system is stable. The blue curve is the bus, three-phase bus voltage. The purple one is the input current of boost rectifier. This time, I will run the inverter with low voltage control bandwidth, which will make the system unstable. With low voltage control bandwidth, you will see when the rectifier starts regulating its output voltage, reach the steady state 270, the system becomes oscillating, and finally, both bus voltage and rectifier output voltage oscillate and diverge from steady state, and production tripped, the system is unstable. In order to predict the system stability condition, I'm going to measure the output impedance of WSI and input impedance of both rectifier. To measure the output impedance of WSI, I replace the rectifier with three-phase resistors. The value of the resistor is tuned to make the WSI running at the same operating point as when it's loaded by rectifier. Here is our DQ impedance tester. To measure the impedance, I just use the PC and the user interface running in the PC to measure the impedance automatically. Here, I already input the command Z measurement AC to measure AC impedance. Once we get the output impedance of WSI and the input impedance of rectifier, we can plot the generalized Nyquist plot, and it can predict the system's stability condition correctly. That's all for today. Thank you.